Hello students, I am Dr. Sangeeta Jain, Department of English, DAVPG College, Varanasi. Today my presentation is about the essay, The Money Box. This is for BA second semester, English Honours students. The Money Box was published in 1925 and was authored by one of the greatest essays of 20th century, Robert Lynn. The essay starts in an autobiographical tone with a seemingly insignificant incident that the essay's niece brings a house-shaped money box from a Christmas party. She wants to know the mechanism of opening the money box. She informs the essayist that no child ever saves money in a money box unless he or she knows the secret of opening it. Any money box which doesn't open is mere wastage of money of parents, as the child will break it open. It is also the wastage of precious time of the child, because the child will spend a lot of time in taking the money out with the help of the chisel. A very simple event forces the essays to reflect on the philosophy and logic behind the creation of money box. That means how this money box came into existence. After he comes to know that no child has ever saved money in the money box, the essayist asks a very thought-provoking question. Is this a universal experience, that no child has ever saved a penny in the money box? That means he wants to know that across cultures and nations, if any child doesn't save money in the money box, what is the reason? Throughout the essay, he tries to find the answer very philosophically, logically, humorously, elucidating with several instances and examples that what is the reason that children never save money in the money box. He further very philosophically reflects upon the existence and emergence of money box when he says, the money box is a monument of worldly wisdom set up there in the guise of a toy by crafty parents. That means money box is not a simple ordinary toy. It has been prepared very cleverly by some clever parents to teach their children the habit of saving. So it is a monument of futuristic logical thinking still extant and present in the world. The essayist elaborates further very humorously that why a child can't save money in the money box. There are so many enticing things like chocolates, toy gun, stamp tickets which lure the child. Buying the attractive things seems more fruitful to the child than having a money box full of money in future. The present seems more reachable than the future vision of a lot of money in the box. Why the stomach which wants to eat toffees should suffer for the sake of pocket which is inhuman and feels no pain, but a stomach is human and feels pain of unfulfilled desires, so stomach should not suffer. That's why the child doesn't want to save money for future. And whatever little money he saves in the money box, immediately when he sees a toffee apple, he takes out the money from the money box and he spends. A child, for the sake of his stomach, widens the mouth of money box with a chisel, like the mouth of Shakespearean clown Falstaff, a humorous, mischievous partner which gives coins generously. A box with wide open slit is the most friendly money box, according to Robert Lynn. The essayist asks an ethical question here, that whether to rob one's own money box is genuine or dishonest. That means if you are taking your own money from your own money box, is it ethical or unethical? Is it genuine or is it dishonest? Now, what is the reason? He explains that every human being has two selves. The self that saves money called the saving self and the self that wants to spend money, therefore addressed as spending self. These two selves are saving self and spending self, and both of them live together just like Siamese twins, attached, joined, but with opposite directions. Both of them always fight with each other, either to save or to spend money. That means if saving self wants to save money, spending self keeps observing that, oh thief, this money belongs to me. And if spending self spends money, then saving self is always observing the spending self. And saving self wants to take that money, wants to save that money. So always both the selves, the saving self and the spending self, both of them are at loggerheads. That means they are always fighting. Then who is the judge? The only judge is the inner conscience of an individual. But it's very difficult that who is right or who is wrong, whether saving self is right or whether spending self is wrong, whether saving self is wrong or spending self is right. So it's very difficult for the inner conscience as a judge to decide who is right and who is wrong. It is always a Waterloo. Robert Lynn says that you could never save money, but there must be a pleasure in saving money also, which only a person interested in saving can feel and express. Finally, he refers to 18th century artist and caricaturist Cruikshank, who drew a series of pictures showing the drunkard's progress from cradle to grave. How well-meaning parents make their child a drunkard by giving an early sip of liquor. Very humorously, he compares that another Cruikshank will portray a series named Miser's Progress. This picture series will show how parents, by gifting a money box to their innocent child, will instill into the child the habit of saving money to such an extent that by the age of 70 or 80, he will have a lot of money in bank, but he will think that he is a pauper because he doesn't know how to spend money. The essay Money Box ends with the note that the only money box which allows a child to take money freely out is the harmless and friendly money box. So which money box is friendly money box, which allows a child to take money out freely? Robert Lynn is one of the greatest essays of 20th century. He wrote under the pseudonym YY. His personal autobiographical tone, philosophical perspective, humorous treatment of the subject makes him very endearing in his writings. It is the style of Robert Lynn that a casual, ordinary topic like money box, a toy still present across the world, has been elevated to the level of literature. By using literary allusions, similes, metaphors, and analogies, he has made his prose very lucid and intelligible. Thank you.